My name is Michel Baudouin-Lafon. I'm a professor at Université Paris-Sud, which is now Université Paris-Saclay. I did all my career here since my PhD. And I started as an engineer, but during my PhD, I discovered the field of human-computer interaction. And so in human-computer interaction, it's a multidisciplinary field that combines computer science, engineering, design, social science, psychology. We try to understand how people interact with computers, and we try to create methods and tools and theories in order to create better interactive systems. So my IRC project is called One, which means one is not enough. And the reason it's called One is not enough is because I think the systems we use today on computers are not well adapted to multiple users collaborating, to the fact that we're playing with multiple devices at the same time, and that we're using computers for many different things. So what I want to do is to really rethink, reinvent the way we interact with computers. Reinvent the windows, the menus that we all know to see if we can find a better system that works better with multiple computers, with multiple users, and for multiple tasks. To apply to an ERC, you have to have an idea you care about, an idea that, you know, wakes you up at night. And then the liberty you have with an ERC is you can write it down, write the project you want to do, and hopefully this passion will move the reviewers. But I think the intellectual exercise itself is stimulating and interesting. If you don't get it, if you don't get it in the first time, you can try again. But it, at least for me, it was very interesting to have this thought process of what would I do if I had the money I need to do the thing I want for the next 5 years. And these projects are not 5 years long. I mean, they will shape your future research. So even if you don't get the funding, the ideas will still be there and you will be able to use them for other proposals. So what's next for me? Well, first I have 2 more years on my ERC grant, so I will be working hard towards fulfilling the project. But I think it's also opening new projects in the future. For example, we interact with computers now that have artificial intelligence in them. How do we want to interact with these computers? Do we want them to do everything for us? Or do we want to be able to work with them or to have them work with us? So I think there are many areas where we can still use human-computer interaction to make computation and computers more accessible to everyone and more useful to different types of users all around the world.